Hello. Welcome to the Novia Conversation. My name is Steve Waltz.
And I'm Jeff Pergelski.
And today's episode is going to be talking about directions. And we're very fortunate today that we have a NAB All-Star with us, our boss, Tom Doran.
Hey, Tom.
Hi, everyone.
So, Tom, before we get into the directions, we thought maybe you could tell our listeners, what is your role here at Novia?
Sure. So I'm the chief marketing officer here at Novia, and that my role, you know, I lead our team that helps us get ready for Summit and helps us get ready for Focus with the NABA community, helps us with our customer conference in the spring for our customers, as well as leading all of our customer engagement folks that are out meeting with our customers on a, you know, quarterly basis and just making sure we're doing a good job and helping them plan for the future and getting more out of their systems.
So, Tom, how long have you been involved in the NAVBC channel?
I've been in the channel for about 22 years.
Wow. That's a long time.
It's, you know, sometimes I look in the mirror and I'm reminded how old.
So you're a veteran. He was the youngest hire here in Novia history on it. Well, great. So, you know, we were talking last week a little about our last podcast, recapping on the customer conference that we had and was a big success. And then we let everybody know that our leadership team was going out to directions. And for some of our listeners, they're not really sure what directions actually is. If you don't mind explaining what directions is and why we attend, that'd be great.
Sure. So directions is the annual. So there's a Directions North America, which is where I recently was, and then there's Directions EMEA, which is for Europe. And so Directions is the Dynamics, what was formerly NAV, now Business Central, partner conference. And for us, it's a really important conference. Microsoft is usually there in force, making sure that we're up to date on the most recent developments with the Business Central product, giving us a little bit more insight into the roadmap, some of their priorities, so that we understand, you know, when customers have asked for features, what expectations should we set relative to when they might be able to see those features. Also gives us a great opportunity to visit with our peers, compare notes, talk about best practices, really help us improve our practice so that we can do a better job for our customers.
So is it a fairly well-attended conference? So it sounds like, is it just NAV partners, or who goes to this type of event?
Well, there's been more and more GP partners there, some SL partners, but historically it was NAV partners. Now we're all in the Business Central community, so Business Central partners. But there were a little over 1,000 people there this year.
That's a big number. And so the amount of Microsoft attendees, have you seen a growth in that over the last couple of years?
Significantly. You know, the relationship with Microsoft has really evolved. And I would just say, and I spoke with many of our peers and they felt the same way. Over the past several years, it's been really nice to have the sense that Microsoft's looking to have a conversation, not to show up and sort of dictate to us how things are going to go. And they really want feedback that comes, you know, through our customers, through us to Microsoft, as well as our own perceptions. And so it's been very collaborative, and we really appreciate Microsoft's support of the Directions event.
That's good to hear. I've seen at the last couple of at least the user group meetings, Microsoft coming out a little bit more at attendance, like you said, with a not more of a dictative message, but, you know, this is kind of the roadmap and actually asking for feedback. So that's good to hear. So, Jeff, what questions do you have for Tom about directions?
Ooh, I have lots of them. I actually hope he's got answers, because I think, you know, for us, things have been changing a lot in the Dynamics NAV Business Central space. So we've had customers with, you know, pending projects and considering projects, worried about licensing changes and how much, you know, user counts are going to cost. And that's sort of, I guess, always we get like a little bit more information from Microsoft each year at these events, right, Tom? So what kind of information did they share about changes to licensing models and pricing and all of that kind of stuff?
Oh, good question, Jeff. There's so much information over a course of 3 days. I guess the highlights. So Microsoft had people there to help lead us through technical sessions relative to the new development environment. So for those of you that don't know, with the fall release, the old development environment will be going away. It will only be the new client. It will only be the new AL and environment. And so that was, you know, shouldn't have been news to anyone, but just a reminder and great technical training from the Microsoft team there. Microsoft also invested a lot of time and energy in giving us exposure to the people that are managing all the system performance and telemetry relative to the Business Central product. You know, one of the advantages of being in a SaaS solution is that Microsoft is constantly monitoring the data to see sort of where is the system being used? How do they make things post faster? How do they make things respond more quickly? The term they used, which I thought was really interesting, they called it wasted moments. They said, when are we wasting moments for our customers and what do we do to improve that performance so that we can help them feel like we're listening? And so that was, there were many great sessions on that. Relative to your license question, I guess there's two big announcements. One, for those folks that are looking at an upgrade, so just a reminder, as of March this past year, so March 2019, there's no more concurrent licensing. So everyone will move to the Business Central named user license. That is a license model transition that will be required with your next upgrade. And then in order to facilitate that change and make it more economically feasible, they announced that there was a 2-for-1 license transition. There was a lot of feedback from customers, particularly our customers, that said, look, that's still too much. And Microsoft has responded with a 3-for-1 license model transition. So for every single one of your concurrent users that you have now, you'll receive 3 of the new named users, which at least in our analysis, more than makes our customers whole. The other piece was device licensing, and that's been really important for folks that have warehouse workers that are in the system or manufacturing folks that have shop floor data collection people in the system, folks that have retail operations with point of sale systems. These device licenses are really how Microsoft has historically rationalized giving each person or each point of sale system or shop floor data collection system an appropriate Microsoft license. That's been in a little bit of limbo for the past several months, and they did announce that in July 2019, those licenses will be available. So we're really excited about those. There's a couple of others, and I'll be quick. I know you asked a short question, but there are others. The release notes for the October. So the release notes, if your audience isn't looking at the release notes, you know, go into Bing or whatever your inferior other alternative for searching might be, and search for Microsoft Dynamics Business Central release notes 2019. And you'll see the April release notes, and within a matter of weeks, you'll have the October release notes. And I will just tell you, if you're interested in the roadmap, Microsoft's done a much better job in laying that out and making it easier for end users to discover. So there was a lot, but I think those are the highlights.
Awesome. Well, yeah, I think that is a lot of information. I will I'd say that I think we've got there's so much information. We've got a webcast plan, don't we, at some point in the future, about where we're just going to talk about licensing and stuff, transitions.
June the 5th, there will be a good session on license model transitions, and any of your listeners, you know, are welcome to join.
Awesome. Yeah. To remind those that are not in the podcast world, sometimes this is consumed on your flat phone after. So if this is after June 5th and you're listening to this and you want to learn more, certainly you can always go to Innovia.com and find our recorded events, and you'll be able to gather that information then. I think that's actually that might even be worthy of a separate podcast, Steve. We'll have to discuss that going forward if we could, if we could keep our listeners engaged for 20 to 30 minutes talking just about licensing. We might need you to juggle or something, Steve, to keep them entertained, though.
I know licensing is an exciting topic, Jeff.
for
I'll
some
have coffee
of us.
Ready. I'll have coffee yeah. ready.
I can tell you this: whenever Microsoft changes the licensing, people get excited.
Yeah, I've heard the term pitchforks before, so I don't know. Now, so anything else? Anything else about directions that you want to share, Tom?
I think those are the highlights. I would just say that, it's just one of many investments that your partner makes. So if your partner's out at Directions and you think, oh, man, I couldn't get a hold of so-and-so, they were at this conference, that is an important investment that your partner makes in improving their business so that they can do a better job for you. And, so give them a break when they're a little slow on a phone call coming back.
Yeah, I know that we have advocated on behalf of our customers directly to Microsoft, and events like this make it easier for us to do that, right? So, anything else, Steve? You had a question, didn't you?
Well, we always talk about on our podcast, Tom, how we try to help our customers and just users in general try to empower themselves. So we're usually plugging in like the Nav user group, and you're a Nav All-Star. And for a lot of our listeners, they don't really understand what that means, is that every year the community votes 3 All-Stars. So we, over the last 4 years, Innovia has received 3 of them. And you obviously run our marketing and engagement team, and Holly is director of our customer support lead. But also, on the other side of things, is that what I heard at Directions, and I saw on Twitter as I was following it, that there was an award that was given on the partner side. So I thought maybe you might want to share who received that award.
So a little softball for me, right?
There you go.
Thank you very much. So each year, the Microsoft Partner Channel votes for what's called the Dynamics Directions Excellence Award. And this year, I was selected as the recipient of that award. And so that was a very humbling and honor that I was completely surprised by. Having done this as long as I have been fortunate enough to have been recognized a few times. I would say the two that have meant the most to me certainly was the NAVUG All-Star Award. I mean, these are my customers. That is a community that I have dedicated a lot of time and energy to. And when end users recognize you as having done something really special, that was great. But I've worked with many of these folks in the dealer channel for over 20 years. And, these are my competitors. I mean, we're sort of frenemies, right? And so the fact that these folks in the channel thought enough of me to recognize me for this award really meant a lot. I was very moved. I do deeply cherish the Microsoft Dynamics Partner Channel, and it meant a lot to me to receive that honor.
Well, it's a well-deserved honor. Many of our customers know that you're very active in the community. You're very involved with the account managers and this, the overall delivery teams, on helping to ensure, we're doing what we say we're going to do and keep up to what our expectations of our customers are. So that to me is an award that you was well deserved, and I think Jeff. Any other questions that you have for Tom before we let him go? And I guess, Tom, I don't know if you knew this or not, but Jeff and I have done, we started a podcast a couple of months ago. He's our boss. We're just kind of having fun with Tom. So, I came back from a user group meeting a while back, and I said, you know, Tom, they asked, you know, what's your favorite podcast? And I kept thinking, you know, what a great way to reach out to our customers. And what Tom normally does is says, I think that'd be a great thing for our customers. So let's do it. And this is our 10th one, Jeff? And it took us a 10th one to get Tom on here. So we appreciate you taking time out of your busy day to get out here. And if for those of you that haven't had a chance, Tom is also an expert in CRM. He's done many different webinars for us on our Innovia website. And he's done several on the Navug website. So there's a lot of other sessions and webinars that Tom has done. And I think you'll be seeing Tom doing some presentations at the upcoming summit.
Great. Well, thanks, guys. I appreciate you doing this and what you do for the community. And, hopefully with your mom and your sister and your wives all listening, that our user group will continue to grow here on the podcast.
We're shooting for 20. All right, Tom.
All right. I'll see you guys.
All right. Thanks, Tom. Yeah, Steve, I think that if, probably with the addition of Tom to today's episode, we might get our we just have to be careful. We don't want to get our podcast. The number of our podcasts can't exceed the number of listeners we have. So as we hit podcast number 10, we got to make sure we have at least 10 listeners. So, So that was great. It was good to have Tom on here. Anything? I know you are coming back. You're like fresh off the airplane from a user group meeting, right? Where were you this week?
Well, let's see. Since our last podcast, I was at the Atlanta chapter meeting, and then I just got back from Austin, Texas.
Oh, you went to Atlanta without me? I was actually looking through my pictures the last time we were at that I was down there. It was last summer, I think, right? We were at SunTrust Stadium. That was a blast. Where did you meet? Where was the Atlanta meeting this time?
So the Atlanta meeting, yeah, that was a blast. So that was at the Pam and her team do a great job, and they got that venue right outside the Braves baseball stadium, and we got to go on a tour. And I'm a big baseball guy, and I know you are too, so we really enjoyed that. And so this one was actually at a hotel in Midtown Atlanta. And so it was a pretty well-attended user group. And Archer Point and Western did presentations. And then yesterday when I was at the one in Austin, Texas, it was held at Every Corporation. They make a lot of the gaming machines and tickets for the casinos. And there's a I think Sana did a presentation. It was a really good presentation. And I think John from Archer Point did a presentation kind of on upgrades. So it was all good content. And I think as we go to help support our customers and be involved in the community, I honestly think it's a good investment of if you're a user out there and you're looking to get more information on how to use Nav or BC, get more out of it. These are just great opportunities at the local chapters.
Yep, I would. I'd say I'm excited to attend next week. Our Wisconsin chapter is meeting at Terso in Madison, Wisconsin, and it's going to be interesting because if you remember, they were one of our first projects where we brought them from an on-premise Nav instance to Business Central SaaS on Microsoft's cloud. So it is going to be interesting for them to share their experience. I know it was overall a great project, but certainly presented challenges to both the Terso team as well as Innovia. And so it'll be interesting. We will maybe have to do a recap of that next time. And it would be just like as we're brainstorming here, it would be good to we talked about maybe involving some ISVs as well as, we've brought in a few Innovia staff. We've had, I think, Holly's been on a couple times, Alan, Wine, our CEO. We have had Tom on this episode. It would be good to get some customers on here, wouldn't it?
I think it'd be a great idea. We'll have to get some customers and some ISVs on, definitely on a podcast. And, when you said the Madison meeting in Wisconsin, there's a little history behind the first user group, Jeff. I don't know if you want to tell our listeners about the first.
User group. Actually, we should save that because we have to get Donovan on, our founder, and actually I'm not sure what his position is now. Is he chairman? But I think we should save that story for him. He was foundational, I will say, in terms of setting up the very first user group community in the Dynamics space. So that's let's put that on our list, man. We're gonna have to have like 4 podcasts a week to cover all this content. And that's making Tim nervous right now as he's thinking about all the content he's got to edit and all the expletives that you're always saying, Steve, that he's got to edit out. And
I'm getting better. I've tried not to have a potty mouth. And we got to make sure that we're not going to get calls from Alan that we're having all these billable people on these podcasts. But so far we've been really, I think, pretty good on that, don't you?
Yep, I think so.
So anything else, Jeff, you think we should talk about here, or?
No, I'm thinking about the. I think we've done a good job of covering. Tom did a good job, I should say, of covering the highlights of Directions. It's always an exciting time of year for Dynamics partners as we, get a little bit more in sync with what Microsoft's doing, and then I think with that's we've got the Microsoft Inspire Conference, the Worldwide Partner Conference. It goes across the Microsoft solution stack. So we will be there as a Dynamics partner. There will be there'll be Azure partners. There'll be Skype for Business, Microsoft Teams partners, OEM builders. Like the whole, it's 30,000, I believe, Microsoft partners show up in Las Vegas. So that's coming up in July. It seems like there's always a conference to go to for Microsoft, doesn't it?
Yes, it seems like Vegas has been the destination for the last couple. So, but that's something that maybe someday I'll get to go to one of those meetings.
I did see that they announced Directions next year is going to be in Orlando. So,
There we go. Get to see my son and burst down for Disney. Maybe I can start working on that one now.
Exactly.
Get a free trip out of it. So.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, you could. It would be beneficial. You could see your. Speaking of kids, I just dropped my daughter off at the airport. She is on her way to Krakow, Poland. She's spending 2 weeks in Central Europe with her business scholars program. So I'm going to start introducing my kids you should start doing this too, Steve. Like our kids who need jobs in the channel, we have to start like pumping them up here in the as dads. We have to start doing that in our podcast, maybe.
That's right. Not that my son just graduated from Purdue with a selling degree and is looking. So I still and also I'm still waiting for the last podcast. I'm still waiting for the boiler up email to come in. So to win a free Innovia backpack, just email me boiler up, and we'll get you taken care of. And so, Jeff, I think we're going to wrap up here. We appreciate Tom getting on the podcast. We almost got Tom to laugh. It was close.
It's about as close as we get, right? He's a pretty serious guy.
Well, he's serious when it comes to NAV and we're executing and making sure we're taking care of our customers. And we do appreciate him taking time out of his busy day. So for Jeff and I, we appreciate everybody listening to, I think, our 10th podcast. And we look forward to our next one.
All right. Thanks, everyone.
All right. Have a good rest of your day.